adventure. TRANSPIRENAICA 2024.
Guys, welcome back to a new video. Finally, we are on the Pyrenees. It took us 2 days to get here, two long days of driving. We made a first stop on the Alps and a second stop in the Camargue. It was really nice. We stayed next to the sea on a beach where it was allowed to do free camping. And now finally, after two long days of driving through South France with a very warm, very high temperatures, it was very challenging. Now we are finally on the Pyrenees. We arrived here last night and we are ready to start our crossing of the Pyrenees. We have 1000 kilometers ahead on the Pyrenees. I can't wait to start it. And this morning we are on this little hill. We still see the Mediterranean Sea down there. We are close to Coilur. I don't know how to pronounce it, sorry. This is actually the starting of all the trail, of all the track that goes all the way to the Pyrenees. This morning I woke up quite early. I wanted to see the sunrise. It was nice. It was very nice. And our jeeps are just behind here. What to say, guys? I'm so excited. I'm so excited to start this adventure. We are two jeeps this time. I'm with Giuliano and Silvia. Thank you. right, so we are finally in Spain. We arrived in Spain and we took a trail, an off-road trail, which was quite hard actually. Very rocky, steepy, but we managed it. And on the trail we found a Spanish guy who stopped us and he said, "What are you doing here? This is a private road. You cannot be here. It's 3,000 euro fine." And I said, "Okay, sorry. I was following a truck actually. Actually, I have two trucks. Both of them were taking us to that trail. So I don't know." And he was like, "Okay, you can go this time, but please remember this trail is private. You cannot be here." I said, "Okay, I'm sorry. I will not come back." So yeah. The first impression of Spain is really nice. The landscape is really good. We arrived to this monastery, except for this guy, for this misadventure. But okay, it was fine. He let us go. Now we are back on the asphalt. We are now going to possibly a lake, because here is very, very warm. So hopefully we will be able to cool down by this lake soon. So see you soon, guys.
Thank you.
Alright, so it's 11 a.m. We are back on the road and we are on this trail. We have seen anyone. There is no one around. So we are driving on this trail for kilometers. We spent the night on this trail and we crossed anybody. Literally, guys, the Pyrenees are amazing in this sense. No one around and it's really wild. Only some cows, but no humans. No cars, no bikers, nothing. So many different places we have seen. Now we are at around 1,000 meters of altitude. Not a lot, but still quite enough not to have warm and hot. It's good. We have 22 degrees. It's perfect. So now we will continue the trail, which is hopefully taking us sooner or later to an asphalt road where we will then take our way to Andorra.
The Pyrenees are a unique place for observing various animal species due to their rugged and wild territory, which has so far prevented a high human density. Of all the species present, however, it is the griffon vultures that accompany us throughout our journey. We observe them along the entire mountain range, from the lowest hills to the highest peaks. In addition to the griffon vultures, there are many other species of birds of prey, which are maybe difficult to recognize by inexperienced eyes, but certainly with their flights, they gave us very suggestive scenes. But to take us through the smuggler's paths that connected Andorra with Spain is not only the vultures. It is here that we meet Alex, a young and talented French overlander who will be our guide for our adventure in the next 2 days on these wild mountains. Alex and I had never met before, and we did not even know each other. We only follow each other on Instagram. However, when Harry sees that I'm about to arrive in Andorra, he contacts me and we decide to meet to get to know each other and to travel a few kilometers of dirt road together. Henry Redbeard. This is his nickname. Also a video maker, has recently moved from France to Andorra, and with him we immediately establish a very strong feeling. It's like if we were longtime friends, even if we had never spoken before that day. And so it is that, without even realizing it, what should have been a couple of hours to get to know each other and did something become 2 days that we spend together. this morning we woke up to rain, this does not stop us from exploring these ancient routes that were used by smugglers to export tobacco. The route winds for kilometers and kilometers on the border between Spain and Andorra, between coniferous forests and large grassy and green plateaus, between altitudes that vary from 1,500 to 2,000 meters above sea level. And we have also the opportunity to have some fun with some puddles and test the capabilities of our vehicles.
Place where we can go and be alone. So come away with me, nobody has to know. Where we gonna go? I was just calling to see if you're free to run away with me, to run away with me. Don't tell your friends, we'll let them know we're safe later on. Skin sleeping under stars when it's gone. I was just calling to see if you're free to run away with me.
Soon it's time for lunch, and we find the clearing near a stream to stop. The rain continues, but thanks to my alluca boning, we still manage to have a shelter for 4 people. And Harry cooks us one of the best burgers I've ever eaten in my entire life. Enjoy!
Les Japonais ou les Coréens, ils font des setups énormes. Ils mettent des auvents, des annexes, des machins, les petites bougies, le petit banc, les trucs gonflables. Le fromage bombe.
Yes, good job.
Yeah.